fixed. Did you guys see that? I saw that. That was coming. I wish I didn't do that.
Katie, you want to tell them what a word you got?
Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
And well, oh, I thought the door was going to slam and then I just didn't. So, like, that was really, like, anticlimactic. Anyway, so I just duffed my face with some chicken. It was good chicken, though. Basically, I got my hair done, like, 4 days? No, not 4 days. Like, a week ago.
What's today? Wednesday? You got it done a week ago yesterday. So, it's been done, you got it done Tuesday.
So, yeah. And I got it blonde, and it was nice and blonde, and I was, like, living because it's summer, and my hair is blonde. Well, it's almost summer. I kind of like to think that it's summer.
I think it
feels. It feels like it, so, yeah.
I guess.
And it was great. Then,
on
went to
Thursday.
California on Thursday, 2 days after I get it done. I take a shower. In the shower. On set. And in the shower was toning, like, brown, like, dark brown toning shampoo. We just looked at the camera the same way. That was so weird. Oh my gosh. Anyway, so I used toning shampoo. It is so hot.
I want to put the top down.
No.
I'm going to put the top down.
No.
Yes, I am. What? Katie, your hair, what? It's kind of messy now anyway. You're going to get it fixed, right?
Yeah.
Here we go.
So I got my hair done, and then I used the toning shampoo.
2 days later.
2 days later, and I had no idea
like
what toning shampoo. It was like black. It was literally black. I put it in my hand, and I was like, this isn't gonna hurt my hair, right? Nah, I'll use it. So I used it. And then my hair became like a brown brown.
Like literally, she went in blonde and came out in the shower blonde and came out of the shower brown.
Brunette. It was terrible. It was awful.
No offense to brunettes. You look beautiful.
No, I just like my hair better blonde, and we paid up a trillion dollars to get it, like, done, so.
Okay. 2 days later, bam.
And then I talked to my hairdresser, Jessica. I was going to say Veronica, and then I was going to say Jessica, so I was going to say, like, Veresica. Jessica. And she said that if I mix a bit of Dawn soap with, like, my regular
shampoo.
It'll help take out the color.
And it did a little bit, right?
It's not that dark now.
It's a little lighter.
But it's just not as light as I have.
Actually, I really like that color.
No.
I think you should stick with that.
No. Anyway, so I'm gonna go get my hair fixed by Jessica, and then I'm going to Natalie's to put on makeup and look good, and yeah, and then we're going to the track banquet.
For outdoor track.
We never had a cheer banquet.
Yeah, yes we did.
We had like one team dinner.
No, we had it at that restaurant, remember?
Oh, right.
Right, the downfall of coming to the salon too often is that we get fat because look at their chocolate display. But that's not even the good chocolates. Katie got the good chocolates up there. Show us the wrapper, those lint. So Katie made me promise to hold her to only two. How many did you eat last time we were here?
Like seven.
Oh, okay. She's gonna do two right away. So when we leave, you can't eat one, you realize.
Look at it flowing in the wind.
my luscious hair. Oh, next up is banquet. I have to go get ready.
Can you get
I don't
up?
Even know.
Like, you
yeah.
guys wear, like,
dresses? We're gonna get cute, but I don't know. I don't know.
Okay.
I really don't know because I don't have any.
Oh my gosh, you have so many clothes.
Yeah, except not really. I have clothes, but like the thing is, I like always have the same amount of clothes because I get new clothes, and then my old clothes, the ones like I get rid of them. No, I get rid of them because it's like stuff that I don't enjoy wearing. Because it's like too small or too weird or too crusty.
Oh my gosh.
But then I get new clothes, and then instead of adding on to my clothes, it just bumps out the old other clothes that I wore before.
So you basically wear everything once, and then you get rid of
them. That's not true. That is completely false.
Okay.
That is so false.
Why don't you wear what you wore to the wedding?
No, that's too fancy for this affair.
So if you could choose anything, what would you choose? Would you choose a skirt, a dress, pants, shorts? What would you choose? Culottes?
Culottes? What is that?
Culottes. You guys, do you remember culottes from the 80s?
Nobody's that old.
Yeah. There'll be people watching from the 80s. They're like pants, but they're kind of thick, like wide. Yeah. And they are like, go down to like here.
Oh, I would wear this.
You would wear culottes.
Uh-huh.
We can go into that bag of yours. I think you put your winter clothes away too early. Like, there's
no,
some clothes in there.
No, I disagree.
Well, like, you won't wear a wool sweater, but there's, like, some cute things in there that you could totally wear. Hey, why don't you wear your new skirt? Why don't you wear your new animal print skirt? That'd be adorable. Right?
You're right.
Yeah. And you can wear it with that white shirt that, like, is flowy, kind of. The one that has long sleeves and it's...
No, I'm going to wear it with my long sleeve black shirt.
What long sleeve black shirt?
The one that Nana gave me.
Oh, okay, that's cute, right?
I've worn that shirt 80 million times. Don't even call me.
And your Nana gave it to you. It's like a hand-me-down from Nana. Isn't that funny?
Yeah, but it's like
she
a crop top.
She has the best clothes.
A crop top. Yeah. And I was like, how? What, did she wear a crop top?
No, she's just little. So for her, it was like a normal length.
In the back, it's long.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I see her rocking it with leggings. I don't know what she wore it with. All right, you guys, we are going to go home so Kate can get ready, but I think that would be perfect. Are you now texting Natalie to tell her what you're going to wear?
It's going to be a very hot summer. That's Tom Scherz's new song. It's called VHS.
Oh, that's good.
As soon as I saw the palm trees on your t-shirt dress.
You've been kind of listening to the new Thomas Rhett album nonstop.
Yeah, literally nonstop.
Do you guys know the issue about Thomas Rhett this time around? Do you know Katie was supposed to go to see the Thomas Rhett concert last year? We bought her tickets for a surprise her with tickets for her birthday to the Thomas Rhett concert.
And I was so excited. But it was the same weekend as homecoming, and I know that sounds bad. Like, oh, she saved it for a dance. Like, no, it wasn't just the dance. It was the dance and the football game and the parade. And if I was gonna be
You're
gone.
A cheerleader.
And I'm a cheerleader, and it was like
you didn't want to leave it.
Come on.
I get it. Freshman year.
And, like, but also, I was going to be home in time for the game, but if you don't go to, the parade, then you couldn't go to the game, so I was going to be at the parade anyway, so that I couldn't go to the game, so you're like, maybe it's just best if I
don't go to the concert.
Stay home.
So we sold the tickets. So then this year, Thomas Rhett's coming back. So.
And he has his new album out, and I literally want to just off myself because he. What'd you just. That's not it. Oh. She's trying to hit the well. Did you guys see that? I saw that. That was coming. I wish I didn't see that.
Really it's on video. You can watch it again and again and again. Lucky you.
Oh, that's awful. Anyway, so.
So you were
this
gonna.
This video is not sponsored by Hydro Flask, but there's still ice in here from this morning. And it's been sitting in this hot car. Hold on, I got my hair done.
Awesome.
Very hot summer.
So we're talking about Thomas Rhett this year.
Anyway, so this year I'm going to Indiana with my church for a church camp for a week. And guess when Thomas Rhett is? The same week. So one day I will see Thomas Rhett. I'm doing it for the good of the church.
What if we fly somewhere to see him?
No. I want to go to Meriwether with all my friends and be like, oh my gosh, I know all the songs and you don't.
Oh, I see. Because
like,
you want to be able to scream all the songs.
Yes.
Yes.
Because I literally know every word to every single one of the songs. Actually, hold on. I'm still like getting in. So I know all the words to like Center Point Road, That Old Truck.
You're talking about for this new album?
For this new album.
But you know all the words.
All the other albums, I know all the words too. But Center Point Road, in other words, too. That Old Truck, Look Who God Gave Her, and Don't Threaten Me With a Good Time. I know all the words to this. But like Sand and Notice and all the other ones in this new album, I'm still like learning. So we're just gonna hang up on you guys so that I can play the rest of these songs. So we'll catch you later.
Bye guys.
I can't reach because of my seatbelt locks. Kisses. See, I'm so obsessed with my hair.
What's happening in here? Did you just call your brother Brett Ryan?
Yeah.
To come in and help you with homework?
No.
To do what? Mm. Were you doing homework or were you playing a game?
No, I'm doing homework.
You just wanted him to come in and hang out?
No.
What did you want? Poor Brennan has an ear infection.
I see you milk coach.
Did you?
Yeah.
He has water polo practice tonight like he does every night. And, hey, are you going to swim practice?
I don't know.
It's at 6 o'clock. You should go.
It's 6:10.
Oh my gosh, Ryan!
I'm doing homework.
All right. So Brennan is taking some medicine, and he played, how many water polo, 6 water polo games this weekend? Yeah. 5 in one day. 7, because 2 in one day, and then 5 in the second day.
Yeah.
It's enough to give someone an ear infection.
Six the second day.
We played 6?
Yeah.
Mm-mm. 3 14 U's and 2 18 U's.
3 18 U's.
You played 3 18 U's? Because you played your 16 U, then an 18, then a 16, then an 18, then a 16. Mm-hmm. Sorry we're bothering you.
Yeah,
I
gotta go.
Right.
Okay. All right, guys, I'm gonna go take Katie to her track and field banquet. Do you guys have any parting words
track
for me?
Track and field banquet?
Mm-hmm.
Respect.
Sounds horrible.
Thank you. Oh, I'll try to hang in there.
Can you bring me back some food if they have some?
You know what it is, though? It's dessert, so yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Call me so.
Okay. Love you guys.
All right, well, love
you too. Bye.
Katie just coming in and doing it, so a very bright future for her, Katie Donnelly.
This is my third bowl.
Of what?
Of macaroni.
Honey, we bought pizza for you. All right, Kate and I just returned home from the what?
See, I stuffed them full of double macaroni so I could get more pizza.
Oh, that was a good idea. No, that's wrong. That's totally wrong. We just got back from the track banquet. Katie, you want to tell them what award you got?
What?
Katie got an award.
What? Yeah, Rookie of the Year.
Rookie of the Year. How about her?
Hey,
so
awesome.
You got a Roy.
Canada's a favorite, though.
Do you think so?
I think she came in.
Yeah. All right. Well,
favorite.
That means that she at least backed it up, right?
Did you make a speech?
No.
Would you like to now?
For me.
Was it?
Yeah, Coach Bostic talked about it.
Oh,
like talked about what she did and stuff.
The ball was great. Congratulations, Kate.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
Such fun. Any
goals? Yeah.
Yes. Still go to practice.
It's humbling to get an award like that.
Huh?
Yeah.
Still go to practice. Eat 2.5 bowls of macaroni and then eat some pizza.
Perfect. How's your ear?
You
have an ear infection?
Yeah, my ear. I can literally hear like 50% of the things that came from my ready the whole day.
Oh my.
I still can't hear it.
That's terrible. How's it feel? Did you take that aspirin for the pain? Ooh. No. You just flung pizza on my dress. Are you kidding me?
Come on.
Brennan. Thank goodness we have Grandma's special secret sauce to get it out. Did it work? I don't think that's actually what it's called. But my nephew told me about it. What?
I have.
Yes, but you don't get all sixes. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yes, you may have a plate. Excuse me, buddy. Are there plates in here?
Bro.
No. Okay. What?
I have a perfect idea for a challenge.
Oh, bring it on. Should I be recording it or should it be a secret?
Probably be a secret.
Okay. All right, you guys, we'll come back with what made us happy and whether or not we like Brennan's challenge idea. All right, so Brennan told me his idea for a challenge. I think it sounds pretty good. So stay tuned to see what Brennan's challenge is. In the meantime, we've got laundry going, and we have basketball. The Raptors are playing the Golden State Warriors.
I said Warriors in five, but it's going to be Warriors in six because I didn't know that Kevin Durant and Klay Thompson were going to be... Well, I didn't know that Klay Thompson was going to be injured and Kevin Durant was going to be out for this long.
Oh.
They're going to win in Oakland.
Okay.
Game six. It's not going to be game six.
All right, prediction. Prediction. You heard it here first. All right, what made you happy today, B-Man?
Driver's ed was
really fun. Oh, good. Well, yeah, Brennan's taking driver's ed, you guys. He's going to get his license soon. Stay tuned for that.
I'm going to make up classes
now. Yes, you have one more class to make up, right? Okay. Awesome.
And yeah, so that's pretty much it. And I got a lot of work done today.
Yeah.
I did a really good quick write in first period. And then second period, I did finish my political coloring book for Gov.
Nice.
Yeah, I drew some out my chair.
Congratulations.
Check some things on my list.
How's your ear feel?
Not good.
Okay. Take your medicine before you go to bed.
I can't. It's 12 hours.
Oh, right. Okay.
I'll take it tomorrow morning.
What made you happy today?
What made me happy today was... What did I do today?
Ah! Today you went to school.
Yeah.
You came home. You did not go to swim practice. You did your homework. You basically went to school and did your homework. Yeah.
Yeah, I did a lot of homework today. Which makes me happy, I guess.
Yeah. It didn't make you happy doing it, but it makes you happy that it's done, probably.
Yeah.
I understand that. All right, good night, students. I love you. How about the pizza? Did that make you happy?
Yes.
Well, that was good. What made me happy today was several things. I would say definitely Katie getting that award at the track banquet. That definitely made me happy and proud. It also made me happy, her hair, she's happy with her hair again. Made me happy, hanging out with Dad. We're planning a road trip for the summer. Actually, they're doing it right now. You wanna see? There's Dad. What made you happy today, Mike?
Oh my gosh. What made me happy, proud was Katie. And happy was arranging our very cool trip that's coming up.
Yeah, stay tuned. There's gonna be a road trip across the United States. She sure did.
Yeah, Rookie of the Year.
Rookie of the Year on the track team. All right, you guys, so comment. Hey, Don, what made you happy today?
I worked a lot of overtime.
Okay. Excellent. You're like Ryan. He said he did a lot of homework. It didn't make him happy at the time, but he's happy that it's finished. Same deal. All right, you guys, that's Don. You've met Don before. He,
I'm happy that we switched to Glacier.
Excellent, they're planning. Alright you guys, comment below what made you guys happy today. We hope you had a wonderful day today, and we can't wait to see you tomorrow, so stay tuned. Bye.
Thanks for watching. Be sure to thumbs up and subscribe. See you later.